Hello friends, I'm Paul Shinn from the Boomerist Car Channel on YouTube. Today we're going to be talking about the 66A, or the Ford Model A that changed everything. It was Ford's first fleetside pickup truck. Today I'm at my friend Gary Bungard's shop. Gary Bungard owns a 66A truck. I know lots of people who know lots about the 66A pickups, and from what I'm told, there's only about 17 of these trucks left out of the 300 or so that were made. And as far as I know, this is the only one that has a metal top on it instead of a fabric top. Now, I've been lucky enough, out of those 17 66As that are left, I have actually set my hands on 7 of them, which is kind of unheard of, I guess. So this truck, although it came from the East Coast and Gary brought it out here to the West Coast, I had heard about this truck, I had seen this truck in pictures, heard people talking about this truck, but until Gary bought it, brought it out here, I'd never actually touched it. Now I actually have. So I want to show you around this thing, give you a little bit of a tour of this very special Ford Model A. You'll probably notice a little bit of fan noise in the background. It's 105 outside, so Gary has the fans on in here. He doesn't want the cars getting too hot, and he's blowing some cool air into the shop right now. So there's a Ford Model A club here that's taking a tour of some of the grounds. So while I have the shop to myself, I figured I'd take this opportunity to go over this pickup truck and share it with you. So this truck is 1931. Although there were rumors that some 66As were made in 1930, we found out that's not true. All of them came out in 1931. This was probably the latest truck out of all of them. And what makes this truck really special is this top. So some of you Ford Model A aficionados will know the Bud Cab, the late 31 pickups that have the metal top, but never on a 66A. This one's unusual, and you can tell it's a 66A not only because of these railings and the unusual tailgate, some of the other features. The fenders are special to this truck, and there's a few other little things inside and some clues. But for the most part, when these were built, they were designed to work. These were not trucks that were going to be collectible. They weren't going to be fashionable. They were work trucks. The majority of these that were built were for General Electric, and they had refrigerators and things in the back. They didn't treat them very nicely, so most of the beds of the 66As don't look as nice as this one does.
To get an idea of what this truck looked like when it was new, here's one that I videoed a couple of years ago in Doug Clayton's collection.
On May 1st, 1931, Ford released the 66A as a promotional vehicle for use by General Electric. It was based on the 229A service car, and unlike the other Ford Model A pickups, the 66A has a polished stainless radiator shell, headlights, and cowl band. The Deluxe pickup is very distinctive with its wide bed and sides connected directly to the cab, and unique chrome-plated side rails. The tailgate and hardware is unique to this model. It's believed there are only 17 Deluxe pickups left in the world.
The seating position in a 66A is not unlike any other Model A truck. The steering wheel is in about the same spot, which is close to my gut because I am a man of girth, and everything is in the usual spots. What makes this different from a lot of Model A trucks is this. So right above me is a metal roof and metal bows. So the only wood in this thing is some wood trim in the panels to get everything to nail to it, and one strip along the back of the cab. That's it. All the rest of this, metal. Another really interesting fact about the 66A, this is the model that Ford carried over into 1932. People say, well, Model A's were built only through 1931. Not so. So there were 293 66As built in 1931, according to Steve Plucker, who is fantastic at his Ford Model A research. But there were 59 of these made in 1932, and we're guessing this is one of those. Every one of the 66As made has the indented firewall, which you'll see here. They call it indented because it's got this indentation in it because the fuel shutoff valve is located here under the hood, not underneath the fuel tank inside the car. And then you also get the side bowl carburetor. So if you know anything about 1931 carburetors, you know if you come across a side bowl carburetor, grab it. These things are getting rare. So even into 1932, although the Model B was in production, you could still get a Model A motor and a 66A pickup truck in 1932, but only 59 of them were made. Something really interesting to note on this truck is this water pump. So you notice typically a Model A water pump has an open frame. This one has a lid on it with some screws holding it shut and a grease fitting on the side. This is really unusual. I've only seen another one. Well, I have one in my shop sitting on a shelf, but I've only seen another one of these on a 66A. So I'm not real sure if this was a water pump that was carried over or if this was added for 1932. Steve Plucker or maybe Doug Clayton or somebody would probably know. But it does mount to the original Model A mounting points and everything else is the same as the Model A pump. But it's got this cover and this thing is completely sealed. You just pump it full of grease and that keeps everything locked solid and lubricates everything all in one shot. Kind of a neat setup. I've seen taillights located in a couple different places on 66As, but this seems to be the factory installed location, although you could move it back here, but the problem is the tailgate comes all the way down. You don't want anything blocking the tailgate from being able to come all the way down so you could easily load or unload things from it. But at the same time, you want them to be visible. So I was always kind of curious why Ford didn't just mount up here on the side of the bed or something, but I don't know, this seems to work just fine. So speaking of tailgate coming down, in order to do that, one simply moves these clips and down she comes. Now this has chains here holding this one flat, but if you were to take the chains off, this would fold completely down all the way and just hang straight down, which gives you full access to the bed for loading and unloading. So these latches for the 66A are really unusual. I wanted to show you how they work. So this pin goes through this hole and then this latch comes around and sticks down in there, and that's how you keep the bed secure on a 66A.
First available in mid-1931 and only as a closed cab with bedsides overlapping the rear cab pillars and attached with carriage bolts, the 66A bed is topped off with chrome-plated brass rails, giving an elegant look to this otherwise utility servant Model A pickup. Briggs, the same company who built four-door bodies for Ford, also built the bodies for the Model 66A Deluxe pickup, which was the first swept side pickup available and the grandfather of many later car-framed fleetside pickups like the Ford Ranchero and the Chevrolet El Camino. Although originally only sold to General Electric Company for their refrigerator repairmen and salesmen, Ford eventually offered the 66A to the public. Tipping the scales at 2,465 pounds, the 66A Deluxe pickup is quite a bit heavier than the 86A and other standard Ford Model A pickups, likely due to the extensive use of wood for the bed and tailgate. Huge thanks goes out to my friend Gary for letting me do whatever I wanted with his 66A Deluxe pickup and for leaving me alone completely unsupervised in this shop with this amazing car collection. This was so much fun. Lord knows I need adult supervision most times, so this was really special.
So thank you so much for joining me for this interesting look at a very interesting and rare Model A pickup truck, the 66A. The first fleetside pickup truck that Ford ever produced, and interestingly enough, one of the last Model A's in production since these were produced clear into 1932. So if you'd like to see me do more reviews of interesting or rare Model A's, just bleep bloop into the comments below, let me know please, and I'll see what I can do. So thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you on the next video.